Hello, good evening and welcome to my video blog. As regular viewers of my video blog will know, I'm a supporter of the Stop the Trolleybus campaign, which a large number of local residents groups have banded together behind the A660 Council, Joint Council, to resist. On Tuesday, there was a planning board review day from the Leeds City Council Planning Department concerning this extremely massive undertaking which they propose to inflict on us all. I was given 6 minutes to speak on the subject of Headingley, which is to me the central part of the scheme, as it involves a bypass, but it is nonetheless scheduled, as they intend at least, to pass all the way through the city centre and out into Hunslet. However, we intend to make sure that scheduling never takes place. So I will just now read to you the text of the speech which I gave to the planning board on Tuesday. So I'll just read from this now. I started by introducing myself. Claire Randall, A660 Joint Council. As a resident of Leeds who may be forced to pay for this project, I wish firstly to state the overwhelming opposition of the community to it and our belief that it is a waste of government and council taxpayers' money at a time of austerity. My comment on this section is that while the aims of a trolleybus system may seem laudable, it would irrevocably damage Headingley. Our beautiful heritage area would be carved up for what has become, what has been acknowledged by Richard Lewis, councillor, as being a highway scheme more than one of public transport, and, I believe, be held up as an example of short-sighted thinking in years to come once the damage was seen. I understand that older residents of Bramley still mourn the loss of the original character of their area. I can only hope that councillors will think again and not inflict a similar fate on Headingley. Councillor Carter, Conservative, has stated that is not the preferred option and has referred to, quote, NGT with its undoubted problems. Councillor Galton, Liberal Democrat, has said that there are questions unanswered. Some of the problems and questions which have not been properly addressed at consultation concern the loss of heritage in what is largely a conservation area, where there are many trees of mature years, some dating from Victorian times, and detriment to English heritage listed structures. There are more mature trees, stone walls, old Victorian buildings, communities and other things of value on this stretch which would be threatened with destruction and consequent loss of character to the area and other issues than I can itemise in the time allotted to me. From Alma Road, where a 19th century cottage with architectural character and good repair is in question, behind the Arndale Centre, where stone walls would be lost and dozens of mature trees would have to be cut down. On Wood Lane, mature trees and a large late Victorian house, which is occupied and in good repair, would be lost, making homeless some 7 people, including 2 children who attend Shire Oak School very nearby and 1 adult who has lived there for 20 years. Headingley Hall Retirement Home would have its buffer of beautiful mature trees stripped away, and a swathe cut through those on Shire Oak Road, behind the Telephone Exchange, Ivy Lodge and the old gatehouse now of St Columba's Church, where a representative has told me his community supports this objection. St Columba's and its caretaker's lodge would be on a traffic island, effectively, sandwiched between roads. Across the meadows of Headingley Moor, the last remnant of Kirkslavy's sheep grange, where Victorian planted trees would be taken down and partial loss of an old stone wall would occur. New plantings to replace the loss of century-plus old trees is not acceptable. Every inch of the proposed bypass route is already either usefully employed or beautified by nature and heritage. There is no brown field or derelict land. On Headingley Lane, the setback of walls required for the proposed road widening would be extensive, needing to build up several metres in place, and Rose Court Children's Playground would be severely reduced. From Ford House to the end of the former Leeds Girls High School, there are at least 4 listed structures, of which three would be affected or demolished. Under the 1990 Planning and Listed Buildings Act, there should be no detriment to these or their curtilage, the surrounding environs. Morley House Trust for the former Leeds Girls High, Ford House and Rose Court have expressed support for this objection. All along this section of road are mature trees right up to the small businesses at the end which would be lost. The redesign of Victoria Road Junction and Hyde Park would involve loss of green and buildings. It is a plan which would spend 90% of its capital budget on the road building and public compulsory purchases, and only 10% on the transport itself. Richard Lewis has told me, in response to a direct question I put, will it be stopped if the local people don't like it? Absolutely, he said. All the local resident and community groups that I am aware of on the route are against it. The sheer immensity of the destruction and upheaval in an area so rich in visually aesthetic heritage and environment would, in my view, as a professionally qualified art therapist, be detrimental to the well-being of local residents for the loss of aesthetic surroundings, especially to the old and vulnerable, who would likely suffer a significant degree of culture shock due to the perceptual stress of seeing so much of their accustomed local world destroyed before their very eyes in order to satisfy the travel needs of passers-through. On the principle of make polluter pay, it is these people who should be made to take some responsibility for the problems they cause with their traffic and not make the local residents pay with the destruction of our heritage. I would invite councillors to walk this section of the route with me and witness firsthand the many beautiful mature trees which have intrinsic value in their own right, and make the character of Headingley what it is before voting to destroy them, their surroundings and their contribution to air quality, which would not be helped by the failure to reduce existing traffic which the current scheme offers. You do not preserve the environment by destroying it. It has come to my attention, and I understand that at the City Centre Plans Panel in 2005, Councillor Taggart said, this is Councillor Taggart, was the chair of the meeting yesterday, Headingley is the jewel in the crown of Leeds, and we should welcome anything that benefits Headingley. This would not benefit Headingley. And I should like to ask Councillor Taggart and all councillors to benefit Headingley now by rejecting these plans. So that's the speech that I had 6 minutes to give to the council panel, which was not by any means a complete session of the city council, which has 99 members. But there was perhaps a dozen. These did seem to be some councillors from along the route, but I'm not sure if they all were. One of the things that I think is most concerning about this is that they are continually talking as if this is just inevitable. They are going to do it, and the only function that consultation seems to have is to bring the design consultants into operation, and they make some minor little tweak to their design freezes, as they're called, when actually at the meeting yesterday there were a fair number of objections. Each section had at least one objector. One section had three, so unfortunately they had only had 2 minutes each, and there was only one person who spoke in favour, and I'm not sure who they were, but I don't think they were representing a community group from along the road. And yet Leeds City Council is planning to put ahead with this in complete disregard for population, even though Councillor Lewis has, I've said yes, if the people don't like it, it won't go ahead. Are we to believe this? I don't know. But we are quite determined to fight this all the way, because it is a completely destructive scheme which has entirely dubious benefits and which has many, many questions about it. For instance, something that came up to my mind yesterday when I was looking at the Yorkshire Post story on this was a couple of technical things about this trolleybus. I'm standing aside from my environmental and heritage concerns for the time being, but looking at the technical aspects of this, I know that some of these trolleybus systems have existed for a long time in foreign countries, but what they tend to have is systems with multiple redundancies in them, so that if there's a blockage or a power line goes down or for some reason something like that happens, then there are enough multiple backups for it not to make a significant difference. This is the only way I can imagine that these systems can work, because it occurred to me, and I should have thought of this sooner, but nobody else has ever mentioned this, that, well, just to ask the question, what would happen if in a severe storm, and we're a very windy city here in Leeds, wind certainly comes up very fast off the, what they call, I believe in technical terms, the air gap, off the air valley, up the hill from Kirkstall into Headingley, and it's very, very windy where I live. It's windy in Headingley, it's windy at the university, it's windy all the way along that route over Headingley, which is a nice high hill exposed. And at some point a cable's going to come down, and it might take them 2 or 3 hours to get somebody to it and fix it up. Maybe it's come down at night. Even if one of these cables takes a bus out of operation for 5 or 10 minutes, then the whole system grinds to a halt. Even more importantly, while I know that they are building, or attempting, I should say, they would like to build new road lanes and this horrible monstrosity that they propose of a Headingley bypass, it seems to me that at some points they are going on existing highways, and again, I imagine in places like some of these large European cities, probably roads which were made after the Second World War probably allowed service-free road surfaces. But we get roadworks in Leeds all the time, old roads, waterworks, cabling, you name it. And these cable buses can't go around it. There's nothing they can do, absolutely nothing they can do. I cannot believe that all of the entire route is on service-free surfaces. And even if they were, what do they do? What do they do when these surfaces need roadworks of just restoring the tarmac? Because they are going to share some of these, you see, I'm being got by their neurolinguistic programming. They would tend to occupy some of the same roads as regular cars and buses. These need resurfacing from time to time. You've got a fixed cable line above. I don't understand how these things work. Perhaps they have technical fixes for this, but they certainly haven't talked about them, and it needs explaining at the very least. Well, there is so much more I could say about this, and I'm not going to talk for much longer this evening about it, except to say that it has sparked off a whole lot of ideas in my mind about other related issues, which I shall have to deal with in my regular video blog, in which I often deal with much more philosophical matters, and I want to get into that as the underlying stuff behind this. But for the time being, I will just leave this with the straightforward presentation that I gave to Leeds City Council on Tuesday, a few comments about some of the issues around their intended implementation of this disastrous scheme. And I will look forward to seeing you on some of my other video blogs if you find this interesting, which I hope you will. If you are a resident of the City of Leeds, and particularly if you are a resident of anywhere along the A660, such as Headingley, West Park, Woodhouse, Hyde Park, Hunslet, Belle Isle and Stourton, or even if you care about the city centre getting messed up with silent buses ploughing across in front of the City Museum, knocking over unaware pedestrians, I would urge you to get in touch with your local councillor, whoever they might be, and ask them respectfully to vote against the implementation of this ill-thought-out and disastrous scheme, which I feel that the City of Leeds is being bounced into with a very hurried and poorly advised policy. So I'll just leave that for now, and I'll say thank you, good evening, and thank you for watching. Good evening.